Anyway, what I'm supposed to show you about this. Because you rest, You mustn't rest when you're building technique. You have to build technique, and if you rest, you're not building technique. You have to build the ability to keep moving, to keep moving smoothly. So resting is a bad idea. So keep it shifting accents, not shifting rhythms. I know that a lot of people keep shifting rhythms, and that's why I'm mentioning this. So after you build four, and you take the whole pass, then you go 1, 2, 3, 4. Build fifth note, fifth accent, then the sixth accent, and you keep it. That's a little harder again. And you do the seventh, and you do the eighth. By the time you can do all eight accents, you have pretty good. You can make it the kind of tempo you want without accents, and it'll go as fast as you want it to go. Pretty soon you begin to sound like a piano. It's just a short. I selected this because of its briefness. Easy to demonstrate, because this is, when you get to a long passage, like for instance, you will, when you get to these long scales, I can't do it anymore because I'm 94. You have to be able to do it. For instance, you have. You take Lerner Horowitz, and he walks out on stage and plays, you're a stem. How can he go so fast? He doesn't think he's playing fast at all. He has built his mile and a half way beyond what you're hearing. Is that what you're hearing? Is comfortable. Sit back and relax. You're amazed. But that's what happens. You can't go beyond what you're doing on stage. You're a pianist.
Can you share the developers with them?
That is a little bit advanced. But this is that we can take the same little example as he is. Now this is if you want to be a real pianist. You take the first two notes like this.
Very lucky lady, because somewhere early in my career, I was taught that every time
you lift your hand up, you lift it up wrist first, which forces the hand to relax. If you lift it up this way, as most kids do, you get tendonitis. That's what you pay for. It's bad to do that. This is good. Lift up your hand, wrist first. I'm always lifting my students' hands off the piano to see if they're relaxed. If the hand doesn't hang, I'm not doing something wrong. Good question. Important question.
Other questions?
Well, I was. How do you maintain focus when you're practicing for that amount of time, even if it's just 2 or 3 hours? How do you maintain the focus?
I'm not too smart.
I can speak to that. So one time I was in her house and we were going to go to a concert that night. And so she said, I need to practice. So I was sitting there on the couch just listening to her practice. And I was actually starting to make noise and was worried that I was going to be disturbing her. And the focus was like that. And we talked about the various people who have worked with her in the past and had, like, she spent the time in her house or whatever, that when you go up, you almost have to go up and shake her because she's, like, in the zone. It's like she's nowhere near anybody else. You're just there by yourself. And last night she was practicing, and I came up, and she didn't see me, and I had to come over and touch her so that she wouldn't be alarmed. She has her own little world, don't you?
If you would demonstrate again how the difference between striking the key and say you had a student that did that and how you would get them to push into it and make it sound melodious.
So she's wanting you to show how to push instead of strike. Demonstrate one more time.
All right. This is striking. I come from my top and I play. I want a C major chord. I have my hands ready to play a C major chord. That's a C major chord. Does nothing. Now I want to push. I have my hands on the keys. I push my shoulders forwards and put my weight. Do you hear the vibration from that? It's warm. It's a pretty sound, isn't it? Decay in sound from when you hit the piano is immediate. Decay seems to grow when you push the piano this way. See, it's still growing. It's still vibrating. That's longer than I ever needed, but it's still vibrating. I don't know how the piano moves.
Other questions? Should we play that duet for them that we worked last night? Do you want to do the fourth or the Brahms or the Rachmaninoff? Would you rather hear the Rachmaninoff Italian polka or a Brahms Hungarian dance for duet? Tell me the story about the Empress while I'm using that voice. Tell the story about the Empress playing duets with you. You can do that.
Usually, I play the top part. Went to the White House to play with President Truman. I had a concert that afternoon. I didn't know I was going to play at the White House. I had this phone call the night before, and sitting at my neighbor's office, and this person at the other end of the phone said, "Do you have any plans for tomorrow morning?" And I said, "Yes, I have to practice. I have a concert at Constitution Hall. I have to walk on stage at 2 o'clock, and I've got to practice in the morning." So he He said, well, we'd appreciate it if you'd clear that whole morning. And I said, may I ask what this is about? And they said, we are not at liberty to tell you because what may happen may not happen also. And I was ready at 9 o'clock the following morning. I had my dress on my arm and I had my music. And I thought I was going to Constitution Hall to practice. And he said, well, before you can practice, there is one place you have to visit first. I said, where? Well, you'll see. And I was put into this car, and this nice American flag, and the fender, and very elegant. He drove, and so that's the White House. And the car went into the White House, and instead of going in front, it went to the back. And my first thought is, oh boy, I have to play. Because the artist never enters the front. I'm going to have to play this one. He put me up in the elevator, put me in a little room, and said, would you like some coffee? Would you like some donuts? Would you like? And I said, I need to practice. He said, well, in due time, we cannot tell you. We don't know. So I waited. Waited every 20 minutes. Are you comfortable? Please wait. Oh my gosh. After about 2 hours of waiting, all at once these two men came in. All right. The two of them whisked one on either side faster than I could walk really. Upstairs, start walking. I start looking everywhere. Pretty soon we come double doors with a marine here and a marine there. And they see us coming, and pretty soon, they open the chicken. There's Harry Truman! When the piano practicing stopped, he had his problem solved. That's the way he solved his problems. He looked playing the piano, letting it stew for a while till he made his mind up. Wonderful gentleman, big smile, nice easy. He said, opened up the piano bench, took out music, it was a slow movement of Mozart sonata, and he said, you take the top part. So I did. And we played that movement that he had practiced, the solo movement of one of Mozart's sonatas beforehand. Mozart wrote several of those for himself and his sister to play. And that's what we played, and then everybody clapped. And then these two gentlemen came and just whisked me away down the hall. I said, I didn't even get a picture. A few weeks later on, at my address, Harry Truman sent me a picture and autograph, and it has nice words on it, and that picture is now at Southern Illinois University, where I worked for more than 40 years, and so they have all my memorabilia there. Imperial Majesty, and I thought she was playing some Slavonic dances, and so I got my ticket, and she just sat at my right. So I played secondo for her, but she played very well. Big thorn in her side is that she never learned to memorize, and she felt she didn't have as good training as her friend Queen Ingrid of Norway.
Mm-hmm.
major people, major, I was just telling a cellist friend that she actually, her family's friends with Annville Mall, but we'll keep that for later. So we'll see you back at 11 o'clock. Please enjoy the piano and play. This room is available between now and 11, so you can do that. There's plenty of time.